attracts one another to have power over her body. The movie might be scary, but the true story is truly terrifying. The Conjuring. While most people know about Ed and Lorraine Warren's case after the success of The Conjuring, it's still surprising and terrifying knowing that the movie and the universe are based on true events. The first movie follows the Warrens as they attempt to help the Perrin family survive a paranormal haunting in their new farmhouse. The haunting began almost immediately after the Perrin family moved in without any information about the dark and tragic history of the house. The real estate agent apparently knew the history but didn't disclose anything, only suggesting that they leave the lights on at night. They didn't keep the spirits at bay, including typical paranormal activity, like the house creaking, door slamming, and whispers at night. The Perrin family and Lorraine Warren helped oversee the making of the movie about their lives. The Watcher. The Watcher tells the story of the recent true crime events regarding a young couple moving into a New Jersey home and immediately finding they made a huge mistake moving into this particular home. The couple, who also moved children into the home, started getting odd letters put in their mailbox. At first it was just odd, and then increasingly became terrifying as whoever was stalking them in their new home knew about their children and knew specifics about their life, including nicknames they had for their children. There have been theories over the years about who was sending these letters from neighbours or even looking into family members themselves. But the Watcher has never been found. The Stepfather. The Stepfather and its 2009 remake is loosely based on the real-life serial killer, John List. But the movie does take significant liberties to dramatise the horror of List's real story. The movie saw stepfather murderer, his family, relocate, remarry, and plan to murder his next family, betraying him as a serial killer. The real event saw John List kill his entire family and move on as if nothing had happened. The bodies weren't discovered until a month after the List wasn't caught until 18 years after the murders. List had relocated and remarried without anyone realizing his sinister past. But there was no strong evidence that he was planning to kill again, as the movie suggests. Dharma. This fictional biopic follows the horrid story of one of America's most disturbed citizens, Jeffrey Dharma. Though Dharma claimed the lives of many victims during his killing spree, this film follows his pursuit of a man named Rodney, known to be one of Dharma's last victims in the movie. In real life, however, Dharma killed as many as 17 young boys and men in extremely painful and sick ways. Extremely wicked, shockingly evil and vile. The movie follows the story of the infamous 1970s serial killer Ted Bundy, who terrorized, raped and murdered young women across America. Starring Zac Efron as Ted Bundy, it retells the killer's story and killing spree across 7 states, including Seattle, Oregon, and Utah. Through the film itself, it's not as gruesome as the real events that transpired. It is not for the faint of heart, and will give anyone who watches it the creeps. More importantly, it proves just how extremely wicked, shockingly evil and vile Ted Bundy really was. The Exorcist. The Exorcist was the biggest horror movie of its time back in 1973. It scared thousands of moviegoers across America. But what many people don't realize is that the movie is based on a novel written by Peter Blatty, which is based on a true story. As detailed in the Denver Post, when a 14-year-old boy from Maryland became possessed in 1949, screaming, bloody scratches on his body, and many other disturbing things. A nightmare on Elm Street. Demons killing people in their sleep has not been proven, but a nightmare on Elm Street was inspired by something truly terrifying. According to Closer, director Wes Craven
Mystery House is